Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic. Now this topic relates to Israel and Palestine issue. So in this class basically we will be understanding how this conflict with respect to Israel and Palestine came into being. So in order to understand this conflict, first of all we need to understand the nature of this conflict. This conflict is more about a conflict between the two religious communities. So the key word here is religious. It's about a conflict between the Jews and the Muslim community. Now why this conflict came into being? First of all, we need to understand that. And in order to know that, we need to understand the phase of colonization. And we need to understand the First World War. Now when the World War I ended, at that point of time, England was in a powerful position. And because England was in a powerful position, it had favored the Jews community. Now Jews community was one such community that had supported the Allied powers during the World War I. And it was the Allied power that wanted to create a Jews community. They wanted to create a Jews country, and the reason for that was that Jews was one such community that was highly persecuted. It was just to save them from the persecution that this Jews country was created. They were actually promised that a Jews country would be created, and it would be created at a place which was actually occupied by the Palestinians, by the Muslim community. That was the area that was chosen by England after World War I in the form of Balfour Declaration. So the basic thing to know about Israel and Palestine conflict is to understand this Balfour Declaration. So Balfour Declaration was nothing, it was just a promise that a Jews country would be created, and for that England would be supporting, and this was the region that was accorded. So after this promise, lot of Jews begin to came and settle in this area of Palestine. And because the population begin to grow, this led to a kind of a conflict between the Jews community and the Muslim community. And this ultimately resulted in a fight. And this fight that took place between the Jews community and the Muslim community, it was also supported by the other foreign powers. England and France came in support of Jews, whereas the ex-Ottoman countries and the other Arab nations like Egypt, like Jordan, they came in favor of Palestine, though Palestine was not a country at that point of time. So they had supported the rights of a Muslim country at a place which was being occupied by the Jews. So the reason for the discord actually lies in the phase of colonization. It lies in the phase of a promise that was made by the British that a Jews country would be created. Subsequently, what happened? The entire area that was actually occupied by the Muslims, it was taken over by the Jews community with the support of England and France. And subsequently also the support was provided by the United Nations when Israel as a country was created in 1948. That again resulted into a war. It was an intestine war. A very bloodshed conflict took place between the Muslim community and the Jews community. That resulted in a kind of movement that we generally call as Intifada. Now this Intifada is a movement against the Israeli community, against the Jews community by the Muslim community. This again has resulted into a lot of conflicts between the Jews and the Muslim community for making this separate country. Like I've told you, this conflict is very old. Now because this conflict is old, now we are actually looking at the solutions. So this class is more about the solutions. After the Balfour Declaration, the promise was made. Israel as a country was accepted by the United Nations. But now, because there is a lot of war going on between the Muslims and the Jews, now what could be the solution for this Israel and Palestine conflict? Now there are two solutions. The one solution is to either create one single state in which there should be democracy, in which the Jews and the Muslim communities should live together, and on the basis of principle of democracy, they should actually decide about how to go about the things. But the things are not that easy. Now, why it is not possible to create one single state, like merging Palestine, merging West Bank and Gaza Strip? That is, West Bank and Gaza Strip, these are the areas in which the Muslims live, the ex-Palestinians live. So this is one solution that is put forward, that all these areas should be actually be merged together. By merging them together, we can create a one single state. But this is not acceptable to the Jews community. The reason for that is, though Jews have access to a larger area, they are present over a larger area, but with respect to the population, they are actually less in number in comparison to the Muslim community. Now, if a country, one single country would be created of the Jews and the Muslims, in that case, the Muslims, they will be more in number. They will be able to have the demographic benefit. And because of this demographic benefit, they will weigh more in democracy. So this is something that is not acceptable currently to Israel. On the other hand, we have a two-nation solution, two-state solution. Now, what is this two-state solution? Two-state solution is that we should go back to the 1967 phase when Palestine had access to certain areas like Gaza Strip, West Bank. So these were some of the areas in which the Palestinians live. Now they wanted that more area should be given to the Palestinians. This is the demand of the Palestinians, that Israel can also live there. Some of the area should also be given to the Palestinians. But this is not that easy. Now, why this is not easy? The first thing is that the areas to which the Palestinians have access, the West Bank, the Gaza Strip, even in those areas, a lot of construction has been done by Israel. So it is very difficult now to actually even divide these areas between Israel and Palestine. Now, the second important reason why it is not possible to come out with a two-state solution is the problem of the refugees. Now, when Palestinians were expelled, they were expelled in lakhs. Now, they're actually residing, these refugees are actually residing in the other areas. It will be very difficult to bring them back and to get them settled in the areas of West Bank and Gaza Strip. So this is the second problem. The third problem, why we can't come out with the two-state solution, is the problem of the city of Jerusalem. Now this is one city. This is one city, a holy city for the three religious communities. It is a religious city for the Jews. It is a religious city for the Christians. It is a religious city for the Muslims. So neither of the three religious communities want to give their rights with respect to having access to Jerusalem. Now when it comes to the east of the Jerusalem, there are certain religious places which actually belongs to the Muslims. Now the west of the Jerusalem has certain areas which actually belongs to the Jews. So the separation is a very tough thing. Now another important thing is that it's not easy to come out with a two-state solution, because even if the governments of Israel and Palestine come and decide about the things, still it is not going to place, because presently, though there is unity among the Israeli community, but there is no unity with respect to the Palestinian government. There are various groups operating for ensuring the freedom and justice for the Palestine. There is a Hamas group. This is one such group that actually wants to have more area. Then there is another group in the form of Fatah. So such groups, they don't have a consensus with respect to how to carry forward this peace process. And of late, United States of America has played a very bad role with respect to Israel and Palestine. It has decided to shift its embassy from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem. So by doing that, it has given a support to the Israeli community. So it will actually result in the re-emergence of the bloodshed. So the days ahead for the world are not good when it comes to the geopolitical equation between Israel and Palestine. So this was all for the class. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. And if you have any sort of query about this, you can WhatsApp me at 84594000. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.